is equal to mod x minus a will have at least one solution if a belongs to which angle. This problem is best solved graphically. So what I do, I plot the graph of these two functions and ensure that they at least meet at one point. So sin inverse x graph is like this. Okay. By the way, this point coordinate is 1, 5/2. Now mod of x minus a graph will be like this, hitting the x axis at a comma 0, correct? Now in order to ensure that there is at least one solution, can I take some extreme case first? Can I say that one solution will exist if the graph were to be in such a position that this arm is exactly passing through this point? Okay. And other extreme position would be when this arm is passing through this point. Right? Between that we'll definitely have a solution. Before that, before this happens, there will be no solution, and after this happens, there will be no solution. So my A can freely move from this position to this position, correct? Now, let us take this position first, number one. Do you see this arm is actually y is equal to x minus a? Correct? Yes or no? And this should pass through this point. So pi by 2 is 1 minus a. So a becomes 1 minus pi by 2. Correct? In this position, in the second case, do you see this arm is actually y is equal to a minus x? And again, it should pass through 1 comma pi by 2. So can I say a will be 1 plus pi by 2? So as long as your a stays between these two values, there will be at least one solution. So your answer will be a should belong to close interval 1 minus pi by 2 to 1 plus pi by 2. Is there any option which is close to this?
No, it's
B.
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 No,
but
D does not include any one of those.
D comes.
Yeah,
that's but
the
D does
C.
Not include.
Yeah, that's
what
I could see.
So ideally there should have been square brackets, but if you say it is not a complete interval, then D can be an answer.
But if it's not a complete interval,
they never said that find the complete interval of A. Complete interval would be included. Any subset of this is also accepted.
C
is also a subset?
Yeah.
Oh.
They have asked the minimum value, right? Minimum value will occur when this becomes. So answer is pi square pi cube by 32. Because you can write this as 4 pi square by 16, so it becomes pi square by 16 into pi by 2. Option A is correct. We have done this question so many times. Next, question number 7017. The first derivative of the function this exists. F dash x exists for all real values of x, then
okay.
First of all, let us find the value of a for this function to exist. Now for this function to exist, this fellow should be greater than 0.
Yeah.
That means this fellow should be greater than
1.
That means this fellow should be less than half. That means a should belong to minus cos x to half minus cos x.
Correct.
And that too for all values of x, isn't it? That's what the function says. So if derivative exists, that means the function should also exist for all values of x. Now here, what is the range of a if x becomes or cos x becomes minimum? That is minus 1. So it becomes 1 to 3 by 2. What is the value of a when x cos x becomes maximum? Correct? Now there is no overlap in this. For the same a, I am getting a different range when I assume my cos x to be maximum and a different range when I assume my cos x to be minimum. There is completely no overlap between these two intervals. So for no such value of a, the function will have its first derivative. So answer is none of these. Are you getting it?
Sir, from that cos x plus a less than half, how did you get the next step?
I assumed the minimum value of cos x, which is minus 1. So that gives me a between 1 and 3 by 2. When I assume the maximum value of cos x, I get a between minus 1 and minus half. That means for all real values of x, my intervals themselves are disjoint from each other. So there is no such value of a for which the function itself will be defined. And forget about its derivative to exist. So the answer is none of these. This is not possible. At least I should have a common set of values of a, na? Even though I am assuming extreme cases. There is no such common set of values of it. Question 71. Question 71 says, which of the following statements is incorrect? Incorrect. If f dash x is greater than 0 for all x belonging to the domain of the function, then f of x must be a 1-1 function. This is a correct statement.
Statement is incorrect.
Yeah, yeah. If f dash x is less than 0 for all x belonging to the domain, then f of x must be a 1-1 function. That is also correct. If mod of f of x is continuous at x equal to a, then f of x is also continuous at x equal to a. This is wrong. C is wrong. Consider a case like this. Okay. F of x is clearly discontinuous at x equal to 0, right?
Yeah. Mod f of x is continuous.
But mod f of x would be a straight line like this. So even though mod of f of x is continuous at x equal to 0, f of x is not continuous at x equal to 0.
But vice versa.
Vice versa is true. The converse is not.
Can you verify option?
Okay, let me read option D. If f of x is continuous at x equal to a, okay, and f of a is 2 at x equal to a, and is the point of local minima, then GIF of f of x is also continuous at x equal to a. This is the correct statement. See, let's say there is a function like this. At x equal to a, it is having a value of 2, correct? Okay, and this is the point of minima. Now, if you take the GIF of the function, what does the GIF do? GIF just takes this part and makes it fall on the floor. Correct? It will become like this. This will go on like this, correct? Correct? So, in the interval of 2, the function will be continuous. In the interval of a, the function will be continuous. Because left hand limit, right hand limit, the value will be the same. Had it been a point of local maxima, then there would be a discontinuity. So option D is also correct. So answer for this is C. Correct? 72. What happened?
Sir, I think in the answer key it's D.
D. We'll have to change it. No, no. We wait for Saturdays to go because all the discussions will happen before that. Class 11th is getting discussed. Class 12th is getting discussed now. 72, if y is equal to tan inverse blah 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 blah, find y dash 0. Again guys, this is a very conceptual understanding. IIT may test you on these things. JEE is interested in mostly your conceptual understanding. So such theoretical questions are also possible in maths. Y is equal to tan inverse. Till end up. Okay. So VN method?
Yeah.
VN method? So can I write this as x plus 1 minus x by 1 plus? Similarly, this I can write it as x plus 2 minus x plus 1. Similarly, this I can write it as tan inverse x plus 3 minus x plus 2. Okay, so can I say adding them all will just leave you with x plus n minus tan inverse x? This will be your. So, derivative of this would be. Where do you want the derivative? At 0? Answer will be minus n squared by 1 plus n squared. Option B is correct. We'll discuss more next class.